All right, I will show you guys two ways to do this. First way is geometry, the second way is complex numbers. Here we go with the first way. Have a look. We have the inverse tangent of 1/2. And as we all know, the original tangent is what? Opposite over adjacent. And the inverse tangent, well, we will just have to find an angle, right? So of course, we should draw some triangles. And this right here, we should also have a triangle that the opposite is 1 and the adjacent is 3. Okay, so let's do the following. I'm going to give you guys 3 squares first, like this. All right? So again, here are 3 squares. And based on this, I can tell you the angle inverse tangent of 1/2, how it looks like. So have a look. Starting right here, I'm just going to connect here to here. Why? Because you can see that based on this, you can see the opposite is 1 and the adjacent is 1/2. So this right here is exactly what we have in blue, inverse tangent 1/2. Very good, right? Similarly, we can go ahead and connect from here to here. So this angle in red is precisely inverse tangent of 1/3. Very good, right? And of course, you can also look at this and that, up to you. What can we do now though? Well, in geometry, perhaps what we like the most is perpendicular lines. So let's see right here. Let's look at this line in blue. Let's have this perpendicular line. Of course, it will look something like this, but we can, of course, do it much better. If you look at the slope of the line in blue, it's just 1/2. Okay. So that means the slope of its perpendicular line will be -2/1. So now let's have, you know, some precise picture. So what I will do is I will come right here and I'll give you guys 2 more squares. So I'm going to draw one more right here and then draw another one like this. And then what I will do next is I'm going to connect from here to here. Right? And maybe some of you guys have seen this picture before. Yes, it's really famous for this question right here. All right, now this right here is with slope -2/1. And the angle right here has to be 90 degrees because we make it to be. Very good. Now, why don't we connect the dots from here to here? All right. Very good. Have a look now. Earlier, we talked about this angle in blue is inverse tangent of 1/2. Well, if this is inverse tangent of 1/2, so is this, isn't it? Yes, it is. 1/2, right? How about inverse tangent of 1/3? Where is that? Yes, that's precisely right here. Why? If you would like, just go ahead and make your squares. Make your squares, right? I'm sorry about my picture, but make your squares like this. And as you can see, opposite is 1, adjacent is 3. So this right here is the angle in red, namely inverse tangent of 1/3. So the question now is, how big is this when we add them up? Well, here's the best part. These two segments, they are equal in length. You can do whichever way that you want. So we have isosceles right triangle. That means what? This right here has to be what? 45 degrees. Very good. So in the end, I'll write this down right here for you guys. This right here has to be 45 degrees, but we are all adults now. So be sure you write down π/4 like this. Very, very nice. Okay, so now have a look. Let's go ahead and do this with complex numbers. So I'm just going to look at this right here, right? In the complex world, we will be talking about the complex plane. Let me draw the complex plane right here. So here is my real axis, and here is my imaginary axis. And now for the angle inverse tangent 1/2, we will consider the complex number 2+1i. Why? Have a look. On the real axis, let me just move up to 2, and on the imaginary axis, let me move up to 1. Then I will just put a point right here. Again, this is 2+i. And I will connect from here to here. And isn't this picture really similar to what we did earlier? Yes, right? Now, have a look. Well, you can talk about the distance from here to here, and you can also talk about the angle from here to here. And in complex world, this right here is called the argument. So I'll put down argument of 2 plus I like this. And usually for the argument, especially for the principal branch, we would like to keep it from negative pi up to pi, all right? So this is the angle that we have, and we can see this is inverse tangent of 1/2. Now we can actually do the same thing for this. So just have to go up to 3, and then of course we consider the complex number 3 plus I. And you'll see that we can just go ahead and connect from here to here. And then this angle, I'll just put this down. This is the argument of the next complex number, which is 3 plus I. Very good. Now, here is the idea. When you multiply complex number, the easiest way to do it is you first change that to the polar form. So if you want to do that, for this one, of course, you can just change it. And I'll just write down, you will get R E theta, I theta. R E I theta. But we have another one, so I'll just say this is R 1 E I theta 1. Similarly, for this, we can change that and we can write this as R 2 E I theta 2. Right? And the best thing is, if we multiply these two complex numbers, of course, you can see that R1 is just multiplied with R2. Theta 1, theta 2, they are both in the exponent, and the base is just E. So you can just add the exponents, right? And of course, you still have the I to take care of. Then, when you multiply the complex number, you can see that all you have to do is just add the angle. In another word, if you want to add the angle, why don't you just look at the product of the complex number? So this is how we can do. Have a look. I'm just going to multiply 2 plus I, which is this complex number, and then I will multiply by 3 plus I. Well, if you multiply these two complex numbers, you will end up with 5 plus 5i. So it's 5 plus 5i, right? In the end, again, we're just talking about the angle that we care. So pay attention to the argument of this complex number. All right, this and that are the same. So of course, the angle will be pi over 4. And you are done. That's it. And in fact, if you want to solve any kind of questions like this, inverse tangent whatever plus inverse tangent whatever, as long as you make sure the angles are legit, right? You can always do this. Just multiply the corresponding complex numbers, and in the end, find out the angle of the complex number right here. This right here will be the answer. And you can go ahead and try this question on the screen if you would like, right? So now, that's it. Hopefully you guys all like this video, and as always, that's it. Black pen, red pen, black pen, red pen. He's a calculus teacher, uses black pen, red. He does math for fun. FAQs get done using complex numbers, doing marathons. And as always, that is it.